eyes for that, but Barnoldswick get us underway. Here's number three, Webster. Area. Seven is Knox. But manages to get a shot away, but it was always bending away from Jack Atkinson's goal. Cross to cover, fires it forward up towards Ben Wharton, who's been pulled all over, but Gilboy gets away. He's inside the box, gets a shot away to the near post. Keeper turns it round for the first Berry corner of the evening. The night before the match. Here's Lewis Gilboy for Berry. Brings it over halfway. He's got space to attack. The defender, Webster, is chasing after him, closes him down, but brings him down right on the angle of the 18-yard area. And Jack Tinning standing over the ball. It's going to be Tinning to deliver it in towards the back post, but he's got way too much on that and holds his hands in his head. And my grandson, Kian, is listening at home with his daddy because mummy's gone to a concert. Here's Wharton, brought down on the right-hand side of the area, and appeals there from Lewis Brown, the Barlick defender. Connor Comer is going to deliver this one. It's about a yard outside the right-hand side of the box. In it comes, headed down, still not clear. Wharton heads the rebound into the side netting. Astonishing number.
Here's
Matty Williams on the halfway line, plays it down the right hand side.
Great ball to Gilboy.
Gilboy turns his man. Can he get it across? Tries to go to the byline. Wins a corner. It was quite a good block in the end from Dugdale. And Gilboy earned him that half a yard. And something's gone on in the. I think we're going to have to retake the corner.
Wharton looked like he was pushed.
Run into the front, Anton Smith comes short, but Tinning delivers it in towards the back stick. Denman with a header, downward header, but just to the right of the goalkeeper's right-hand post.
He had to deal with it then, though, because Gilboy was breathing down his neck.
Oh, Hill, that's a terrific save from Jack Atkinson. Really, really good save as the ball was played into the box. Dugdale. Anton Smith wins it back. McWilliam goes past one, goes past two, gets a shot away. Keeper has to get down sharply. Smith, Wharton, turns his man to second defender, gets a toe to it. Wharton's down. And North Manchester, I think.
Oldham, I believe.
Is it it's Oldham. Oldham, you're right. Think, yeah. It is, it's Royal Oldham. So Tom Greaves is on.
Yeah, 34 minutes, Murray.
Goes left, finds Sean Higgins, plays a 1-2 with Connor Comer. Comer with a little dink ball forward to Gilbert, who's inside the area. Oh, ball's just knocked away from him out for a corner. Here's Matty Williams, right on the halfway line, ball down the right-hand side, finds Gilboy, brings it down on his chest, goes in between two defenders. Mick Williams with a lovely turn. Can he get his shot away? He can, but it's blocked. And then steps in, blocks the ball. Great ball to find Gilboy on this right-hand side. Greaves in the centre. What can Gilboy do? Little step over, tries to curl one into the far corner, but it's miles wide. In.
The referee, I don't think he was in a great position.
Comer delivers it in, it's headed clear. Anton Smith gets there first. Comer plays it in first time. Ball comes through.
Goal!
It's a finish by Joe Denman. And the big defender adds an opening goal.
It was a lovely flick on from Lewis Gilboy from Comber's ball into the box, and for a big lad, he's got quite a good finish with his feet, as Joe Denman. Ability.
He's still got 20 goals this season, though. As the ball comes in, and it comes off Denman, but the keeper was quickly down to it. When we landed yesterday.
Yeah,
Harry Brazell's just made a fantastic run down the left-hand side. Ball pulled back, McWilliam with a shot, blocked. Brazell, lovely first touch and a great second touch, and that ball's going to go over our heads and out onto the cricket pitch.
We're still waiting for a ball here now, you know. There's a yellow card to Bradley Knox for that foul on Adam McWilliam.
Lovely first touch by the youngster. Ball's just knocked away from him. And there is the half-time whistle. So Berry will go in, a goal to the good. Therefore, he wouldn't have been in the playing squad.
Yeah, obviously, I spoke to Jimmy on the up for it, and I think it just helped him as well a little bit, you know, because we know the type of player. Crikey, a bit of a run here from.
Great defending there by Connor Comer. Absolutely. Oh, hang on a minute, and then he's just been crashed into by the Barlick skipper. Sent him flying, but very still in possession there in the right hand side through Matthew Williams. Ball into the middle, looking for Greaves. It's volleyed away, and Tinning wins it back for Berry. Here is Cormer.
Yeah, I think
Denman with a little chip ball down the left hand side as the wind starts. He's a very good creative player, but I just wish he'd shoot a bit more, because as we saw earlier in the season, box. Here's Cormer. Oh, good shot to the near post, but the keeper was behind it. Forced back slightly, but Berry will get it clear. Gilboy. That was a blatant handball by the Barnoldswick number 7.
Well, the conversation to either side of us is that the player's already been booked, so that's
second yellow card is off. So Barnoldswick reduced to 10 men, quickly taken by Greaves. Here's Gilboy, right-hand side of the area, needs to take the ball with him.
I think he was trying to back-heel it into Greaves' pass and just didn't get a clean contact.
Anton Smith with a nice piece of skill there. Gilboy to deliver it into the box. Cormer, McWilliam, Brazel. Here's Greaves. Tom Greaves. Oh, he's just dragged it wide. Little dink ball forward, looking for the run from Gilboy. Keeper reacts quickly.
On Harry Brazel shoot.
Harry Brazel shoots from distance.
Goal!
He scores!
What a goal.
Well, he's going to be 45 yards out from goal there on the left-hand side. The keeper played it. He puts up his hand in apology. The ball fell kindly for Harry Brazel, and he launched it forward. The referee had to duck out of the way, and it just dropped under the crossbar, and Berry have a 2-goal lead from the other side of the park. Berry on the attack again.
What a save.
Well, it was a brilliant volley, side-on volley from Connor Cormer. Berry get it clear. Atkinson tries to spread it out wide right. Gilboy just absolutely dropped. Tinning effort on goal. Here he comes, steps up, straight into the arms of the goalkeeper. He's after it, gets it under control, and then the Denman dispossessed. Barnoldswick get an effort away. Good block by Jack Atkinson, and announced his surname, and it's Cormer, like the village in Norfolk. As the ball's played into the middle across the face of the 6-yard area, but goes harmlessly through. Got chance to run forward. The number 11 is going to go in the ball.
Terrible foul,
Ben Ashton.
Why?
There was no need for that.
Absolutely no need for it.
Mr. Gillen, who chose the yellow card. And then a little ball forward for El Hassan.
Here's
Connor Cormer. Shot comes in.
Oh.
Big shake for a handball there. Referee's having none of it. Ball's played into the Berry half, but Denman will just knock it back to Jack Atkinson.
There goes the final whistle.
Is the final whistle, so Berry finished their games on the road with a fairly comfortable 2-0 win. Goals from Joe Denman in the first half, and then a spectacular lob from fully 45, 50 yards from Harry Brazell to give Bury a comfortable 2-0 win.